Limited, and with us we have Bhavadharini. She is HR manager, and Divya. She is social media manager at Air Preservation Private Limited.
Okay, pleased to meet everyone. And what's your good?
My name is Sunmi. Let me.
Lights are going.
Okay, so hello everyone. Hope everyone are doing good, doing well, and staying safe. Myself, Divya, social media manager, along with Bhava, the HR manager, and I welcome all my audience with that we start our today's podcast.
Today we have Siksha Gupta with us, who has 18 years of rich and diverse work experience in many domains. Hi, Siksha. Welcome to our podcast. How are you today?
Hi, thank you very much for having me on your podcast. I'm doing good. Thank you. How are you guys doing?
Yeah, so ma'am, currently you're working as talent acquisition head at Winware Technologies, Bangalore. Being head of a team, how challenging is this role for you?
Oh, what a brilliant question. Being a team manager, guys, is always challenging. But you know, COVID has brought new set of challenges where everybody is working in a virtual environment, right? When you're at office, there is more teamwork, more collaboration, conversations are easy. You can do conference room discussions, brainstorm together, solve problems together. But with virtual working, right, everything has become Microsoft Teams or Zoom. People have to be available. People have to show up in meetings, right? So the coordination and communication, though these are great tools, right? But I feel it's a more challenging environment compared to what it was when we were at office. And I think the biggest challenge is people come from different backgrounds, diverse cultures, you know, different industry experience, getting everybody together and working towards a common goal, you know, chasing a common target. There are people issues, there are stakeholder issues, there are issues with the candidate, all sorts of things are there. But I think, yeah, working together as a team towards one common goal is what the aim is. And virtual environment has made it a little more difficult. But yes, pulling it off, Divya, that's all I can say.
Yeah, great.
That's inspiring to know on your leadership skill. As we know, you are involved in hiring and training our millennials. So what tip would you suggest they to get skilled up before entering into any domain?
Oh, wow. Millennials, you know, when we started, for example, I started, all of you are very young in front of me. When I started my career, say 16, 17 years back, that time, you know, industry experience or corporate readiness in schools, colleges, MBA schools, was not as much as it is in today's environment, right? Today's B schools, right, have guest lectures or corporate lessons incorporated in their curriculum, which make candidates or which make campus hires industry ready, right? There are different programs, there are coaches, there are mentors, there are guides who give them all these skills. Now, these are called coping skills, right? Like crisis management, team management, leadership qualities, collaboration skills, life coping skills, disaster management. All that they get as first-hand experience in today's education system, right? With the industry leaders doing so many webinars, seminars, virtual sessions for all the campus kids. So I think these skills are very necessary. And it's also a good idea to keep reading, right? Reading about your subject matter, your industry, your domain. Always keep yourself abreast with the industry trends, right? What are the market trends? What's happening new in that domain? If you're updated, it's good. Keep following the news, keep following your industry. That's very important. And beyond everything that you may need, right? The right attitude and the right confidence. That's very important, right? In this whole competitive environment that I have to secure a job or I have to get a campus placement first, right? Don't meddle things. Be clean, clear, confident about who you are. Read about your industry. Network with people. Follow what's happening in your domain. I think these are some quick tips that I can think of at the moment. I hope this answered your question, Bharati. Bharani, sorry.
Yes, ma'am. This is really going to be very useful for our millennials. So as we spoke, can you share your role as a president of Karnataka's WICCI?
Oh, wow. Now, Vicky, WICCI is a women empowerment organization, completely a non-profit organization, right? We work on various women empowerment issues, right? Or not issues, maybe avenues, forums, initiatives. So what we do is every week we pick up, say, for example, as of last evening, because October is the Breast Cancer Awareness Month, we did a talk show with three different people from the industry, a doctor, a cancer survivor, somebody who's a part of an NGO who's helping with this awareness. So we touch upon different topics which women are dealing with. We get them to our platform, we do a dialogue with them, we connect them to other organizations, associations, right, and help them. For example, a couple of weeks before, we did something on the small industry day, MSME, medium and small scale industries, right? So we called people who are into handicraft making, you know, candle making, cake making. These are not entrepreneurs, right? Extremely well. They started grounds up, you know, housewives. Some of them were housewives. Some are also working in corporate, but pursuing this as a passion. So how do you empower women, right? Bring them to this platform, connect them to the larger audience, give them a platform to showcase their work, their skills. I think that is what Vicky Karnataka is aiming at. And whatever we can do in this space, we'll continue to do. And we pick up a different theme every week to address different issues, different segments, different sectors, or different walks of different phases of a woman's life. Right. So last evening was breast cancer awareness. Yeah.
That's so great to know about you. Do you believe in this saying of life is not meant to be lived in one place? Because we hear that you have been a globetrotter.
Yes, sir. And that's thanks to my parents. No credit to me. I was born in India, but brought up abroad. So I have done, we've been out of India for a good 25 years. All my schooling, education, degree, everything happened abroad. And right from America to Europe, to Africa, to Mauritius, it's been a very enriching life. You know, when you travel, it's not about, you know, just seeing new places, just seeing new architecture, new monuments and stuff like that. You get a different perspective towards life, right? There are different people, lifestyles, culture. You know, like if you travel in India, India is vast. There's one portion of India which lives in slums. Right? The life is so different. Urban India versus rural India. So similarly, the world is very different. Each geography, each country has its own flavor, people, culture, languages, lifestyles, dress code. So it enriches your life. You get to know, you get to see people, you get to interact with them. To me, I love it, but then COVID, right? Last 20 months, I haven't traveled anywhere, just been sitting at home. And it's also good to see, like, for example, when I went to Rome, I loved Vatican City. You know, the Sistine Chapel, the architecture of Michelangelo, his paintings. It's beautiful. It's beautiful to know about the world's history, geography, culture. I love it. So I think till the time I live, I will continue to travel. COVID goes off soon.
Yeah, sure, the COVID will go off. And that was nice hearing from you. So can I ask, how did the thought of this registering into the TET circle pop into your mind, ma'am?
Lovely. Okay, so I myself have been a part of different forums, right, where I am a participant, right? I'm just a participant. So I thought, you know, I should get people from my own network into a particular circle and we discuss about different topics that TED decides globally, right? So TED is a global community. They decide on one topic for every month. The theme for October is optimism. So I thought I should get people from my different walks of life. And you know what, Divya, my TED circles has people from Europe because these are all my friends, right? I grew up with them.
Yeah.
I have people from Africa. I have people from Mauritius. So it's like a global community. I decided to become a host, pick up the topic given by TED every month. And we get everybody on that platform. It's one and a half hours discussion. I typically do it on a Saturday or Sunday so that everybody can make it. And it's so lovely to see, you know, school friends, college friends, everybody talking about the topic that has been decided by TED. It's such an enriching conversation because you get diverse perspectives, right? Everybody is different. And people outside India share a different perspective, different lifestyle and stuff like that. So I thought it will be my circle, my platform, people from different geographies. And that is what motivated me. And imagine we came back to India 14 years back. I have been able to connect to my school friends through TED circles, because those times there was no Facebook, there was no WhatsApp, there wasn't anything, right?
Yeah.
We used to exchange letters, chitti likhte the, right? We used to have each other's postal address. But thanks to TED, I guess, I hope TED Circles is hearing this. Thanks to all of you. I've been able to connect to my school friends, college friends, and we all join whenever I plan for this meeting. It's amazing. And you should see the kind of conversation we have. I normally do a LinkedIn post once we finish the discussion as to what were the key points that we covered. If you want, I can share some with you. I just started. I've just done three. And I intend doing that every month. It's beautiful.
Sure. You can share it with us. It'll be great to listen. And also, there's a very good way to connect with your friends. You've chosen a very good platform.
Absolutely.
Yeah, ma'am. We wish you good luck for your registration and your YouTube channel. What topics do you discuss there, ma'am?
Whatever. I mean, specifically something, I think, most of it is HR because that's my domain. I've studied HR. I've been working in HR. So HR is my passion. Beyond that, a little bit of youth empowerment, women empowerment, conversations with folks like you, right? Which is, I mean, you're touching upon all the nice memories or nice touch points of my life. Thank you so much for that. Most of it is about HR, leadership, women empowerment, youth empowerment. Those are the initiatives I'm associated with. So, yeah, that's all. I intend starting a talk show, which is on my mind, something just like the way I host TED Circles. It's still work in progress, but let's see where it goes.
Okay. That's indeed great and inspiring to know about you, ma'am. I would say you would be a true example to women power, women entrepreneurship, etc. And you also support all the women. So it is really great to know about you.
Nothing, Divya. I'm just trying to do my bit to the society. See, all of us, right, study so well. We attain a lot of degrees, qualification, experience. The aim of life is not to be born, study, work hard, and then die. Give something back to the society, right? Give something back to people. Give something back. Anybody and everybody, in whichever form or manner. And I'm associated with another initiative. It's a digital CSR initiative called Support Saturdays, where we help all the people who've lost their jobs during COVID. We help them connect to opportunities. It feels good, you know, when somebody gets a job and you have been the reason behind it, or some woman in distress is able to make some business or is able to deal with some problem and you are the reason behind it. Your parents are smiling and you are the reason behind it, right? People around you are smiling and you are the reason behind it. It feels so good. Trust me. satisfaction is different.
Yeah, sure, ma'am. Thanks a lot, Shikha Gupta, for being with us today and sharing your experience. And a big thanks to our viewers for tuning in for our podcast today.
Thank you so much for having me here. It was wonderful and you touched upon the most beautiful moments of my life. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you everyone and stay safe.
Take care.